All right, engineers, we're going to talk about the humerus now. So if you look here, this is actually going to be, this whole thing up here is the proximal epiphyses. But this part right here, this articulating surface right here is called the head of the humerus. It's actually covered with a hyaline cartilage. They call it an articular cartilage. And whenever it actually forms the articulation with the glenoid cavity of the scapula, it actually is going to form the synovial ball and socket joint right there. All right, so now that covers the head. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover this other part of the proximal epiphyses here. At the proximal epiphyses over here, we have this structure right here. This structure right here is called the lesser tubercle. So lesser tubercle. This one right here is the greater tubercle. This right here is the intertubercular sulcus. And then if I move right here, this is the deltoid tuberosity. It's this roughened surface right there. It's where the deltoid inserts. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of pull this back here so you guys can see this. This right here is actually going to be called the coronoid fossa. It's where the coronoid process of the ulna inserts, right? It actually forms that little depression there. Here's the radial fossa right there. And the radial fossa is actually caused by the head of the radius, which causes that depression. This is the medial side of the bone, right? So this is actually, technically, you can call it the medial condyle. But we actually have a specific name for it. We actually call it the trochlea. Then over here, we actually have the lateral condyle. But again, we give this a specific name. We call it the capitulum. If I come over here, this right here is the epicondyles right here. And this right here, since this is the lateral condyle, this is the lateral epicondyle. And if I come over here, since this is the medial condyle, this is the medial epicondyle. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to flip it over and look at the posterior aspect of it. So if we look at their posterior aspect, again, you guys can see that you see the head there and you can see the part of the tubercles. If I'm moving down the diaphysis, and you kind of see this like little like big turn that this part of the bone makes right here. You see that turn? That right there specifically, as I'm coming down to the diaphysis and boom, I hit that turn. That right there is the radial groove. Okay. Now I'm going to come down here. This right here, now we're looking at the posterior part of the humerus. This big, big divot right here is actually called the olecranon fossa. That's where the olecranon process of the ulna just actually causes that depression right there. Now we're going to look at the head of the humerus, but I want to cover two types of necks, the anatomical neck and the surgical neck. So if I kind of take my fingers and wrap all the way around this guy right here, wrapping around the head, that part that I'm wrapping where my fingers are, that is actually referred to as the anatomical neck. Then if I take and I come over here and I wrap this part around the part of the bone, that is going to be the surgical neck. All right, so guys, that pretty much covers the humerus.